If you build it, they will come. That's the famous quote from the popular 1989 film Field of Dreams, based on the 1982 novel Shoeless Joe. Only, the quote isn't actually correct. The real line was, "If you build it, he will come," referring to the protagonist's deceased father. However, pop culture has skewed it to mean that if Kevin Costner's character, Ray, builds his baseball field, the masses would come and he'd be saved financially. That outcome is part of the story, but not as it applies to the quote. Though the field refers to the baseball field with which Ray replaces his cornfields, the film is about far more than baseball. It's a testament to the power of patience, about the transformative power of unwavering belief and the courage to see things through. Ray invests significant time and effort into building the baseball field in his cornfield based on a mysterious voice's message, the previously quoted, "If you build it, he will come." Clearly, this act requires patience as there's no immediate reward or guarantee of success. It also requires patience on the part of his wife, who has heard no such mysterious messages and is putting her faith and trust in her husband and his sanity. Throughout the construction process, Ray faces skepticism and mockery from family members, his neighbors, and even his friends. But he sticks with it. He perseveres despite these challenges, exercising patience with the process, the skeptics, and himself, even in the face of financial ruin. When the ghosts of baseball players past do arrive, they slowly saunter onto the field, one by one. Again, Ray is called upon to be patient and to trust the supernatural message he was originally given. It doesn't mean the waiting is easy. Waiting has been defined in dictionaries gone by as active expectation of good. Not passive, but active. And Ray exemplifies that. The true purpose of the field unfolds slowly, and it is indeed about dreams. The dreams of reconciliation, forgiveness, and fulfilling dreams. It is through Ray's patience he discovers the field's deeper meaning and the value of the experience for him personally. Like the field, he undergoes a transformation. He starts as a disillusioned farmer who along the way rediscovers the joy of connection and purpose through patience and sticking to his beliefs. All involved are blessed as a result. Your tiny task for today is to give thought to how you can be patient with someone else's dream. Does a loved one have a goal you think is unattainable? Find ways to change your thought about the situation to see it as doable, not doomed. Thanks for joining us for another Story Saturday on 11/11. If you've been enjoying what you hear, please consider inviting a friend to subscribe. We'd be most grateful. No rush, by the way. We can be patient.